features in the individual pharynx, isn't it? So first, that is the nasopharynx. The next name for the nasopharynx, that is the epipharynx. Okay, we are seeing the features. Okay, just I'll type the features here and I will explain. Okay, so we have seen the pharyngeal fossa or fossa. That is not fossa, that is sinus. Sinus, pharyngeal sinus or sinus of Morgagni, we have seen. We have got a pharyngeal fossa also, that I will explain later. First, we have seen the pharyngeal sinus or sinus of Morgagni. Okay, so that is the sinus. See, in the upper part of the pharynx, in the posterior wall, just above the superior border of the superior constrictor muscles, the wall of pharynx is made entirely by the pharyngomaxillary fascia only. So this fascia shows the semilunar depression. Okay, so that is the sinus of Morgagni. Okay, so this sinus of Morgagni you have already seen. Let me show you here. So this see here in the upper wall, in the posterior part, so only there is the pharyngomaxillary fascia forming the wall. Okay, so here you will see the depression here. So this depressed portion, so this is the sinus of Morgagni or pharyngeal fossa. So here you will find the opening. Okay, the one opening, that is the opening of pharyngotympanic tube. Okay, just now here remember the, that is the sinus of Morgagni. Okay, so that is the first feature. Okay, next other feature, see here. So you have already seen that also, pharyngeal tonsil. That is the nasopharyngeal tonsil. So this nasopharyngeal tonsil, that also you have already seen. So see, actually it lies at the junction between the roof and the posterior wall. Okay, so the continuation of the roof into the posterior wall, that is, that forms a sloping like structure. Okay, on that slope only you will see the pharyngeal tonsil. So actually there is the aggregation of the lymphoid tissue underneath the mucosal lining of the pharynx. Okay, at the level of junction between the roof and the posterior wall. Okay, so that is the pharyngeal tonsil or nasopharyngeal tonsil. Okay, so that is the next feature of the nasopharynx. Okay, that also you have already seen. So this, see here, you can see here, this is the tonsil, pharyngeal tonsil, isn't it? In next picture it is more clear here. See, can you see this aggregation here? So this is the nasopharyngeal tonsil, okay, or pharyngeal tonsil. Then the next feature you will see here, that is the nasopharyngeal bursa. Our next name for that, pouch of Luschka. Okay, this pouch of Luschka also I have already explained that, see here. Yeah, at the upper part of the nasopharyngeal tonsil, there what will happen? So the diverticula will develop, okay, within the substance of the pharyngeal tonsil, that is the mucosal diverticula. Okay, it will invaginate the substance of the pharyngeal tonsil. Okay, so that diverticula, that is the nasopharyngeal bursa or pouch of Luschka. Actually, this represents the embryonic attachment of the posterior wall of the gut with the notochord. Okay, Just remember this point. So that is the nasopharyngeal bursa, that is the diverticula extending from the upper pole of the nasopharynx within the substance of nasopharynx. So that is the nasopharyngeal bursa. So this is the next feature in the nasopharynx. Okay, are you getting? So next is the remnant of rat case found. Rat case found. So this remnant of rat case found. See here. Actually, see this rat case found. Okay. So if you see the development of pituitary gland. Okay. So this pituitary gland, it has got a two part, anterior part and the posterior. So anterior is the adenohypophysis and posterior is the neurohypophysis. So this actually this adenohypophysis that is developed from the rat case found. What will happen? See during development. So from the roof of the stomatodium, that is the ectodermal roof of the stomatodium, okay, it will form the diverticula. So that diverticula separate from that roof and forms the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Sometime here you may see the remnant of that rat case found in the upper part of the, just above the pharyngeal tonsil. Okay, are you getting? So just above the pharyngeal tonsil, okay, there lies the remnant of the rat case found. Okay, actually this rat case found, okay, that forms the anterior part of pituitary gland. Okay, so this rat case found, actually it is the diverticula arising from the ectodermal roof of the stomatodium. Okay, are you getting?
What is that?
So what will happen, see, during the intraembryonic, like this rat case forms, it is derived from the ectodermal roof of stomatodium. So actually this stomatodium just finally forms the oral cavity. Okay, so that forms the rat case form, that is the diverticula developing from the ectodermal roof of the stomatodium. Sometimes the remnant may you may find in that place, okay, just above the nasopharyngeal tonsil. Okay, then the next features you will see here, that is the opening of the pharyngotympanic tube, or that is the opening of Schuchian tube. Okay, so next feature, that is the opening of the Schuchian or auditory or pharyngotympanic tube. Or auditory tube. So see here, in the either side of the lateral wall of the pharynx. Okay, so there you will find the opening. Can you see this opening here? Here, this below portion, this opening, this is the opening of splenoidal sinus. This, can you see this opening here? Are you seeing this opening here?
Yes, sir.
So this is the opening of pharyngotympanic tube or auditory tube. Okay, so this actually this lies at the level of inferior concha. Okay, 1.2 centimeter posterior to that. Okay, so this is the opening of pharyngotympanic tube. See this pharyngotympanic tube, actually it is the connection between the middle ear cavity with the pharynx. Okay, so this next end will open into the middle ear cavity. Okay, along from the anterior wall. Okay, so this middle ear, it has got a six wall, isn't it? Roof is there, floor is there, anterior, posterior, medial and lateral wall. This pharyngotympanic tube open in the anterior wall. Okay, in the middle ear cavity. So this is the communication between the middle ear cavity and the pharynx. So it opens in the lateral wall, in the both side. Okay, and the opening is lies at the level of inferior nasal concha. See here, so this is the nasal cavity, it has got a three concha is there. So see, this is the inferior nasal concha, middle nasal concha and the superior nasal concha. Okay, at the level of inferior nasal concha, okay, just behind one, it, okay, 1.2 centimeter behind almost. There is the opening, that is the opening of auditory tube or Schuchian tube or pharyngotympanic tube. Are you waiting? Now see, in the margin of the opening of pharyngotympanic tube, you can see one swelling, isn't it? So this is the, that is the tubal elevation. So it has got a next name, torus tuberum. TUBERIUM. Okay, RIUM. Torus tuberum or tubal elevation. So the see at the opening you will find the elevated region. So this bulging part portion in the just around the opening of the auditory tube or eustachian tube. So this bulging, that is the torus tuberus or tuberum. Okay, that is the tubal elevation. So this tubal elevation you will find in the almost you will find in the superior part and the posterior part. That will be the more prominent. This swelling will be prominent in the superior and the posterior part of the opening of the auditory tube. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So many features are there. Okay, here see, can you see here opening? Can you see here? So in this picture, here is the opening. See the margin. Okay. Along the periphery of the opening of the eustachian tube, you will find the elevated portion. So this is the torus tuberum or tuberis or tubal elevation. Okay, so this elevation is prominent in the superior and the posterior aspect. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then the next features you will see. So next feature here, see, just this swelling is due to some structure present underneath the this mucosa. Okay, so underneath this mucosa there is some structure is there. Okay, so that structure is the tubal tonsil. So why this swelling is there, or why there this portion is elevated? Because just under the mucosa of this margin there is the aggregation of the lymphoid follicles. Okay, that is the tubal tonsil. Due to underlying tubal tonsil, so this margin is elevated. Okay, so this is the region where you will find the tubal tonsil. Are you getting? Okay, so this tubal tonsil, actually this is the aggregation of the lymphoid follicle. Okay, underneath the mucosa of the tubal elevation. Due to aggregation of this tubal tonsil just underneath the mucosa, the margin of this, that is the auditory tube, opening of auditory tube, you will find the some elevated portion due to that aggregation of the lymphoid follicle just under that mucosa covering this portion. Okay, so here you will find the tubal tonsil. So due to tubal tonsil only this margin is raised up. Okay, so this rise of margin is known as tubal elevation. So just underneath you will find the tubal tonsil. Okay, then the next structure you will find the pharyngeal recess, that is pharyngeal fossa, or sometimes it is known as fossa of Rosenmüller. Fossa of Rosenmüller, or next name is the lateral fossa also, or some says that is the pharyngeal recess also. Okay, no problem. Now see here. Now if you see just behind the tubal elevation, you can see one depressed region. Okay, so depressed reed like structure. Can you see here? So this depressed region just behind the tubal elevation. Okay, so this is the pharyngeal fossa or lateral fossa or fossa of Rosenmüller. Are you getting? So that is the fossa of Rosenmüller. So just behind the tubal opening or just behind the tubal elevation, there is the slit like depression. Okay, on the lateral wall of the pharynx. So that is the pharyngeal recess or pharyngeal fossa or fossa of Rosenmüller. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just remember these features. Okay, these features you have to write in exam. Okay, then the next you will see the sulfing of pharyngeal fold. So this sulfing of pharyngeal fold, actually that is the fold of mucosa, okay, extending, okay, from the posterior end of the tubal elevation, and they will finally run downward and finally disappear, okay, from pharynx. So this fold of the mucosa, that is the sulfing of pharyngeal fold. Are you getting sulfing of pharyngeal fold? Why this fold is there? Because just below the mucosa of this fold, there is one muscle. Okay, so that muscle is the sulfing of pharyngeal muscle. Okay, this fold is due to the underlying sulfing of pharyngeal muscle. Okay. Sulfing of pharyngeal muscle. So this is the actually that is the fold of mucosa extending downward from the posterior part of the tubal elevation, which run downward along the pharynx and finally it will disappear. Okay, more prominent, and as it moved downward, so it will become faint and finally it will disappear. So this fold, that is the sulfing of pharyngeal fold, and this fold is arise due to the muscle just below the mucosa. This mucosa, there is the muscle. So that muscle is the sulfing of pharyngeal. Okay, so this is the one of the muscle of pharynx. So due to that muscles, there is the mucosal fold will appear in the lateral wall of the pharynx. That is the sulfing of pharyngeal. Okay.
Yes.
Then the next fold you will see here. That is the fold. That is the sulfing of palatine fold. So again, this fold from the anterior aspect, you can see this fold here. Okay, it is not prominent here. So this sulfing of palatine fold is. So this is again the fold of the mucous membrane extending from the anterior aspect of the tubal elevation up to the palate, up to the soft palate. Okay, so that is the sulfing of palatine fold. Sulfing of that is related to the tubal opening. Okay, opening. So here can you see this fold? So this prominent portion here. So from the anterior part, there is the extension of the fold. Okay, of the mucosa from the anterior portion of the tubal elevation. Okay, or opening of the esophageal tube up to the soft palate. So this is the palate only. Okay, up to here. So this extension. So this, because this extension, this fold is there because there is one muscle is there just below there. There is the levator palatine muscle. So this levator palatine muscle, as it cross this tubal elevation, it forms the fold here. Okay. So just below the mucosa of this portion, you will find the levator valley palatine or levator palatine muscle. So due to underlying levator valley palatine muscle, this mucosal fold is arise, or this fold became more prominent there. So that is the sulfing of palatine fold. So this is the fold of mucosa extending from the anterior aspect of the opening of the pericotympanic tube up to the soft palate or up to the palate. And this fold is due to underlying levator palatine muscle. Okay, so there is the muscle, that is the levator palatine muscle. So due to that only, so the mucosa seems like slightly raised up from the surface. So that fold is due to the levator. So levator palatine. So levator palatine muscle. Then the next structure you will see here, that is the passavent ridge. Passavent ridge. Now see here, this passavent ridge here. So there is one muscle is there. Okay, so that muscle is the palatopharyngeus. So this palatopharyngeus. So actually this muscle, see here, the extension of this muscle, see here. So this muscle actually, see, here soft palate is there. See, from the soft palate, see, there is, see, all muscles they will meet in the palatine aponeurosis. Okay, from the palate, this palatopharyngeal muscle extend from the palatine aponeurosis. From the palatine aponeurosis, it forms a U-shaped loop around the lateral and the posterior wall of the pharynx. See, this is only one half is shown here. Okay, now I'll draw here one muscle here. Okay, suppose. Okay, so almost like this U-shaped loop. Okay, this half lies in this side and half in the next side. So that muscles, what will happen? See, it arises from the or anterior is attached to the palatine aponeurosis and it move along the lateral wall and the posterior wall of the pharynx and then finally merge with the fiber of the superior constrictor muscles. Okay, so it forms the almost U-shaped loop. Okay. Are you getting? So palate, see here is the soft palate. My hand is soft palate. Okay. So from here, see, from the palatine aponeurosis, muscles will go backside, and again from the next side also next muscle. Okay. They are in pair. One muscle from this side, so along the lateral wall, and finally merge with the superior constrictor. Then from this side also that muscles along the lateral wall. Then it forms like almost U-shaped loop, isn't it? So this U-shaped loop is formed along the lateral and the posterior wall of the pharynx. Then what will happen? See, this passaventry. See, what will happen? See, during the contraction of this muscle, okay, what will happen? The mucosa of the lateral and the posterior wall of the pharynx, they will be slightly rise up. Okay, while muscle is contracting, what will happen? The mucosa is pulled, isn't it? See, just below the mucosa there is muscle. If muscle is contracting, they will pull the mucosa. Then what will happen? The mucosa, there will be the formation of ridge. The U-shaped ridge will form along the course of the palatopharyngeal muscle. Okay. So this ridge, this U-shaped ridge, just underneath the mucosa of lateral and the posterior wall of the pharynx, due to contraction of the palatopharyngeal muscle. So that ridge is known as passavent ridge. Are you getting? Are you getting this? Or I have to write here? Are you getting? Not yet. Mucosa.
Yes, sir.
I have to write.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Means you understood. Yes, sir. Or I have to write. Yes, sir.
You have to write, sir.
Okay.
Both yes, sir.
Okay, both yes, sir. Along the lateral and posterior wall of the pharynx, see, due to contraction of underlying muscle. Along the, just below the mucosa, okay, there is that muscle is there. So that muscle, so underlying muscle, the name of muscle, the cell that in bracket here, okay. So that muscle is the, see, this muscle is extending from the palate to the pharynx. So the muscle is the palatopharyngeus, okay. Palatopharyngeus muscle. Okay, so this contraction of this muscle, underlining muscle, so that forms the one ridge of the mucosa along the course of that muscle. Okay, so that is the passavent ridge. So the mucosa ridge arises along the lateral and the posterior wall of the pharynx due to contraction of underlining muscle, that is the palatopharyngeus muscle. Okay, just underneath the mucosa. Below the mucosa, okay. So what will happen? So that ridge is the passavent ridge. Now what is the use of that passavent ridge? I will tell. Now before that, I'll go for the next. That is the pharyngeal isthmus. Isthmus. Now see here. See this pharyngeal isthmus or nasopharyngeal isthmus. Same thing. Okay. So this nasopharyngeal isthmus or pharyngeal isthmus means same thing. Okay. So if you want to know the attachment of muscles, the palatopharyngeous muscle, so that is from the palate and aponeurosis, and then it runs along the lateral and the posterior wall, and then finally this fiber will merge with the superior constrictor muscles. Okay, some fiber will merge with the superior constrictor muscle. So that fiber which is merging with the superior constrictor muscle, while they are contracting, they will give this ridge on the mucosa on the lateral and the posterior wall. That ridge, that is the passavent ridge. Okay, so easy to understand. Now see, next is the pharyngeal isthmus or nasopharyngeal isthmus. So actually see this, this is the nasopharynx, isn't it? So this nasopharynx, see, you can see the partition between the nose and nasopharynx and the oral cavity. See, there is the partition, that is the palate, isn't it? So anterior 2/3 is the hard and posterior 1/3, that is the soft palate. So now see here, so this, can you see this opening here? So see this opening, okay, that is the nasopharyngeal isthmus. Okay, are you getting? So now see this opening. So actually see this opening act as a valve. Okay, this has got a valvular function. So they are the isthmus. See what will happen while swallowing the food. Okay, see this isthmus. Okay, this opening they are going to close here. Okay, so that what will happen, the food entering from the mouth to the pharynx, it will not regurgitate into the nasopharynx. Okay, see, if it is not closed, means what will happen while swallowing the food, sometimes the food may regurgitate here, isn't it? But sometimes by some neuromuscular incoordination, sometimes it may go here, isn't it? Sometimes it may go, okay, due to that neuromuscular incoordination. Okay, but generally see, it should be closed. Okay, so while passing, deglutinating the food, so this isthmus will be closed. Okay, just right here. So it will close during swallowing the food or deglutition of the food. See, now the structures around this part, they will act as a valve. Okay, see here the nasopharyngeal isthmus, that is formed by the two structure here. So that is the superior surface and posterior border of the soft palate. Okay, first structure, that is the superior or posterior border of the soft palate. Okay, superior surface and posterior border of sub palate plus next structure, that is the fossa vent. See, read. Now see, so this isthmus, see, it should be circular, isn't it? So anteriorly there is the soft palate is there. Okay, and the posterior and the either side, the contribution is by the this passavent ridge. So what will happen now? See here, you are eating food, you are chewing the food. Now you are, it's time to swallow. So you will swallow the food. Then what will happen? See here, this soft palate, the superior, this palate will rise up. Okay, this soft palate, it will rise up. Then at the same time, what will happen? The muscles, that is the palatopharyngeous muscles also, they will contract. Then what will happen? It will pull the mucosa, and this pharynx will come up. The mucosa will be pulled, so the passavent ridge will arise. So then they will have, what will happen? These two ridges, passavent ridge and the surface of the soft palate, they will approximate each other by closing that opening. So that is the nasopharyngeal isthmus. Okay, so it will prevent the regurgitation of the food while deglutinating the food. Okay. So it will prevent the regurgitation. What will happen if regurgitate? Means it will go to the nasal cavity. So that is prevented by this nasopharyngeal isthmus. So anteriorly there is a soft palate, okay, contributing superior and the posterior surface, superior and the, it is not posterior, this is the inferior border.
So the nasopharyngeal isthmus na hamle epiglottis ni bhanna milcha?
No. Epiglottis is different. Epiglottis, it will be in the larynx. That will come. Don't worry, I will tell that also. That is different. This is different. So epiglottis, that guards the laryngeal opening. We are reading here pharynx. Larynx is different. Pharynx is different. Okay. Are you getting?
Sir. Huh? Yes, sir.
it will close during the one vacuum.
During swallowing the food, you will eat food, you will chew the food, and the food you will swallow, na? So while swallowing, what will happen? This isthmus will close. So how this will close? See, while swallowing the food, see the soft palate, see, is hanging in the oropharynx, isn't it? Now see, it will rise up. Then the muscles, that is the palate of pharyngeal muscle, will contract. Then what will happen? The passage and ridge will arise. Then see, suppose my this U-shaped arch. So that is on the, so this, suppose this is the posterior wall, this is the lateral wall. So this U shape R, that is the mucosal ridge, arising on the posterior and the lateral wall of the pharynx. Okay, suppose this is the posterior, okay, posterior lateral side. Now here is the soft palate, is here, my hand is soft palate. Okay, now I'll swallow like this. Now what will happen, see, during swallowing the food, what will happen? This soft palate will rise up. Then these basement rays will arise. Then what will happen? They will close. They will approximate and they will close the opening. Then nasopharynx is here, oropharynx is here. So the food coming, passing from the oropharynx, it will be prevented to come in the nasal cavity. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
During swallowing or deglutition of the food, this isthmus is closed by the action of this soft palate and the basement rays. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't get confused with the epiglottis. This is not epiglottis. Okay, then what is next? Isthmus. Okay, so these are the features present in the nasopharynx. Okay, then we'll go for the next pharynx, next part of the pharynx. Okay, so what is the next part of the pharynx?
Mesopharynx.
Yes. Now the next name for the mesopharynx.
Oropharynx.
What is the next name for the?
Oropharynx.
Oropharynx. Now see here. Up to here we read. Now see in this picture here. So up to here. Okay. So this is the inferior border of the soft palate. Say this is the upper border. So inferior border act as the act in closing the. Nasopharyngeal isthmus or pharyngeal isthmus. Okay, up to here this is the, okay, up to here this structure, that is the nasopharynx. Now we are going to read the next part of the pharynx, that extend from lower part, okay, lower border of the soft palate up to the upper border of the epiglottis. Now see here, your epiglottis is here, okay, this is not epiglottis here, so this is epiglottis is here. So it has got a different role. Okay, it will close the airway. Okay, I will tell that also. Now we are reading the this portion of the pharynx. Okay, up to here almost. Just I will draw one outline here. Okay, up to here we have to read now. Maybe line is not visible. Okay, I will take the some different color here. Okay, up to here. Now we have to read. Now up to from here to here we have to read. Okay, so.
Yes, sir.
Now this portion we are going to read now. Okay. Okay. Now this highlighted portion. Can you see here this green color highlighted portion? So that is the which part of the pharynx? That is the oral part of the pharynx, or pars oralis pharynxes, or mesopharynx. Same thing. Okay. So this part of the pharynx, it, so the location is just like behind the